Coaster friends, and happy Wednesday! And welcome to the Planet Coaster community stream. Woo, round of applause! Mm-hmm. I am Bo, your community manager. You all know me, and I'm joined today by the lovely, well-known from the community, Andrew Chappell.
Forum infamous, I think.
Exactly.
You mean.
Andrew Chappell.
Hi,
everybody. Nice to have you here.
Thank you. Nice to be here.
How are you?
I'm really good.
Yeah.
We have lots of exciting things to show you. Lots of amazing workshop creations.
I know. I made a list. I made a list, guys. There's a list. I went through all of my submissions that people have been sending me since like December, I think. I'm so sorry. I'm so behind on that workshop thing. There were some people even sending in stuff today. So I combined them and I picked some of the really good stuff. And then I'm going to challenge Andy today to make it all into a cohesive, nice-looking park. So I'm not touching the controls at all. I'm being
what
a lazy backseat
builder. What could go wrong?
I know, right? So I'm trusting your eye for detail
and
everything.
Oh, no. Programmer here. There's no eye for detail.
I don't believe that.
Oh, dear.
Anyways, just to reiterate as well, for those of you who are tuning in since recently or whatever, this is a community stream. We're not announcing any news today. Oh, my goodness. I accidentally opened the Chrome Help Center and it's throwing me off. There we go. We're not announcing anything news today. We are really soon going to PAX East, the beginning of March, where we will be talking about some really cool stuff coming in our mid-April update. Our big update to Planet Coaster is very exciting, and I will post more on that on our social media and forums and everything, so keep your eye on those channels as well.
So there's so many good things coming.
So many good things. Everyone's genuinely excited.
Yeah,
like, there's a good buzz going on.
We had a few wonderful moments over the past couple of weeks where people have been gathered around like people's dev machines in the office and just watching things happen. Can't see anymore. Really want to say more, but can't say
spoiling.
Anymore. No spoilers.
No spoiling. I don't know what it is. Every time I bring a guest on these streams, they're so eager to spoil stuff.
Oh, it's because we all get to see really, really cool things and we can't wait to share it with everybody. But now is not the time.
Fair.
Now is the workshop time.
Now is workshop time. Anyways, I hope you all know noticing as well, sorry, the lovely new background that we have. Let's move a bit to the side so they can see. Look at that! We're in an interactive theme park right now. Isn't that cool?
It's so very pretty.
It's so nice. So it's going to loop as well. So the longer we talk in the screen, basically, it's going to go from day to night and everything. And I have to give a big shout out to our beloved video editor, Luke Ritson, for doing that for me because it makes the stream look so pretty. And I just want to sit here and chat with you guys. Can we do that?
I think we can,
but
I think if we don't show off some workshop things, they're going to get a bit annoyed.
We'll do workshop stuff as well. Can you look at it one more time?
Yeah.
Look at the little coaster flying by over there. Yeah,
there it is!
So nice! Anyways, welcome, thanks for hanging out with us, and first off, let's check this out. Look, I implemented a whole new batch. I say I, it was not me. It was Ian and Andrew from downstairs, who are awesome magicians, and they helped me implement 5 new featured creators this month. So welcome to Channel 5 Gaming, Hexer Zero, Pharos, SSD, and Uthris. You're all well known in the community, you're well beloved, you're great content creators, and you deserve to be on that list. So thank you very much for having awesome workshops. And to celebrate you as new featured creators, I picked from each of you some items as well to show off in Andy's upcoming park.
Fantastic.
So yeah, that's good news. I've seen some of you in the chat as well. So hello, well done. And next month, March, we'll have a whole new batch of featured creators. If you think that you have an amazing workshop collection going on and you have awesome skills and whatever, send me an email at community@frontier.co.uk and let me know that you want to be a featured creator as well. And then I can add you to the rotation. And I think
I think I've done my talking.
Yeah, go for it. I'm handing over the controls to you, and feel free to just open a park and start building.
Let's have a new sandbox, shall we?
And I remember from last time that you're very good at talking and building at the same time.
I'll try. What type are we going to go for?
I don't know. Shall we ask the chat?
Yeah. What park should we create, chat?
Give Andy a nice park to create. They will get 30 seconds to do this because they have a little delay on their side. Last time you were here was in November or something.
It was ages ago.
I thought it felt like yesterday. It really, time has been flying by. It's crazy.
No, it's been super busy.
Yeah, I know. We had launch and everything. Desert, grassland, tropical, arctics, alpine.
I think everybody's there.
I should have thought of this before I... Oh, boy.
Okay, let's go for desert.
Okay. You can give it a cool name, I don't mind.
Cool desert name.
Oh, they're all saying Arctic now.
They're saying Arctic.
Oh, boy.
Oh, no, we've picked desert. We're going with desert. But desert. What's a cool name?
Call it something like Chappell.
That sounds a great park name. Yeah. I just get the keyboard on the mouse.
There we go.
A
beautiful setup. Cool desert names, says Games for Tom. Exactly, Game for Tom's on my level. That's what I was trying to do.
Fantastic.
So yeah, as you know, like all the items that I subscribe to are in my blueprints.
Right.
So feel
then
free to
let's go find the park.
However you want.
Let's have a look.
Oh, I'm so excited.
What have we got? What have we got?
Hi, Gregor Burns. Thanks for coming.
Ooh, we've got an Alchemist Tower.
Yeah.
Let's start with an Alchemist Tower.
Very cool. The Alchemist Tower was made by Mohs. And
that'll give us an excellent starting place.
It's nice. It's very cool.
There we go. What is it supposed to be on? It's supposed to be up. Oh, no, no. Trees down
there.
Yeah, exactly. Let's get that. There we go. Right.
He's concentrating, guys. So you are a lead programmer.
I am indeed.
And what have you been up to?
So I have been getting all sorts. I've been working with our team of programmers on all sorts of wonderful new features to show off for PAX and getting all sorts of crazy builds and things ready to show off.
That's exciting. And that's all we can say.
Yep,
literally all we can say because we can't spoil.
Nope.
Also, if you have any questions about programming, game development, about any, feel free to pop them in the chat. And I will relay them to our lovely guest. Ooh, look at you.
Going for some curvy
What is hats. Happening inside that tower over there, by the way? Is there a little witch in there?
I think
there
might
be. I'm sorry, I'm distracting you.
Let's finish that path.
Hi, Vampiro. Nice to have you here.
Come on,
as well.
Have a look. In here.
See Charlotte in the chat, and the Lady Zyner's here.
Look at that.
Hi, Zenith team. We want Spoiler Sam. You'll get lots of Spoiler Sam at PAX.
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, look, there we go.
Oh,
there's
wow.
a little witch inside. And
a friend.
Yeah.
That's
that is lovely.
That's really nice. Cool. So that is a Mohs Alchemist Tower.
Yeah.
Very nice.
Very nice. Let's take that one off.
Crescendo
there,
Chris 98.5 asks, "Hi Tommy, what language is Planet Coaster in primarily?" C sharp.
No. Planet Coaster isn't in C sharp. Crescendo Chris, it's mostly written in C++. We have some Lure as well, and we have a little bit of C# for our tools and things, but most of the game's written in C++.
That's really cool. I don't know what that means. I'm just going to assume that's really cool. I saw a question from Osric as well, saying, what has been the trickiest part to program?
The trickiest part to programming Planet Coaster is always the sheer number of things we have in the world at any one time.
Yeah.
So we get these amazing parks that our designers create, and even more amazing parks that the community create that have hundreds of thousands of objects in them. And
yes.
be able to run that fast enough and with detail enough so all the peeps look amazing and they know where all the different shops are and everything else just is... just the sheer size of things is amazing. And we spend many, many hours to get it to the point where you can build these giant parks.
Yeah.
At as good a frame rate as we possibly can. There's still more improvements coming, but that is an amazing programming challenge.
I can imagine. I don't even know anything about it. Buddy Kimbo is on message and he says, Planet Coaster is mostly in Planko. Winky face.
Yes,
correct.
It's true. I think
James
Stanton would be adamant about that. Planko is mostly in Planko.
I'm just writing down some questions that I'm missing so you also get some time to build.
Cool. Yeah.
And
in the interest of putting down some rides as well, I am going to put down a quick ride.
Ooh, actually, there's a ride skin in there as well.
Is that?
For the carousel.
For the carousel. Let's have a Venetian carousel then. That's Cheroplane. Why do I always think that Cheroplane is the carousel? Every
because
time.
Because they have these lovely roofs going.
Yeah. I think it's the roofs. Right, let's give ourselves
Oscar is asking, where is Edvaret? Hi, Bolvaret. And then we're missing Silveret. I think you're a Silveret fan. Edvaret is enjoying his night off because he streams twice a week for Elite Dangerous as well. So I'm not dragging him along every single week. Oh, that's
rest.
A good question as well.
There's a carousel skin.
Yes, so this is by one of our featured creators of this month, SSD, who makes primarily ride skins, I have to say.
Oh, fantastic.
And they're very, very good and detailed. I really like them. So yeah, you should be able to place it down quite properly.
That's still floating, isn't it?
Can I get? Can I work at Frontier to get exclusive? Says Abzul Elise. No, maybe. I mean, we all sign NDAs when we work here. That's how the gaming industry works.
That's the sad thing is that even when you know all of these amazing things, you still don't get to show them off.
Exactly. All right. There we go.
Right. Let's give ourselves a cue to avoid the checklist.
All right. I forgot to write down someone's name. Sorry. This was Dirk Techno. Doing a terrible job of taking notes today. Alright. This may be a PAX spoiler question. Yard of Terror, hello! But will we... Oh no, I cannot even. That is a spoiler question and you almost tricked me. You almost tricked me. Oh boy. Lorenzo says, this is a good idea, the queue for this ride. Yeah, it's nice. It goes like nicely around
very,
the ride and everything. If you feel like building it, go for it.
Yeah, let's.
Andrew's being absolutely... I keep like switching between Andrew and Andy.
Either is fine.
I know,
everybody,
you don't mind. I'm
everybody
just like,
just
oh.
Switches.
Are Frontier employees allowed to work on side projects for indie games? Well, Mikkel Burbank, that just depends on what you're doing. That depends on your NDA. And
Frontier's pretty.
It's a trust relationship, isn't it?
As long as we talk, as long as we talk with the bosses and let them know what we're doing, they'll say whether it's okay or not.
Right.
Generally speaking, it's fine.
Yeah.
Let's make that a bit shorter. Not that short. That'll do.
It's just so nice. I like it when you're in a desert park and you're building lots of green stuff.
Yeah.
Or like colorful stuff.
Oop.
It's good.
There we go. Right.
Megan Cooksley has a nice question. Are there any themes that you would like to see in the game in the future, personally?
This is not an
answer that's going to guarantee that it's coming in the game. This is a personal opinion answer, just so you know.
So, I am a big fan. I really love the sci-fi theme. Most of the Bible in my part ends up being sci-fi. But I know that the Halloween theme, the spooky theme, is always popular request. Even
it's
in the office, that one's
one.
A popular request. So I would love to see more spooky themes.
Ooh, cool! But there are some really cool items in the workshop
people have made amazing
scenery stuff.
Whenever I grab a dark ride from the workshop and it's just full of scary scenery, I'm like, how do people create this stuff?
I know. I think there is one of the blueprints that we have is a dark ride. Oh, this looks nice. You know what? You only put down two things, I think it looks nice already.
I thought I had created that, but I'm missing a piece here.
Oh, it's
hang on, it's no.
What have you done?
I'm not sure what I managed to do. this is the programmer's curse.
Mikkel Burbank, Andy does have a Twitter, but it has a funny handle. If you go to my Twitter, you can in my latest tweet about the live stream, you can see his handle.
Yes. Yeah. No, that is a very old handle I've had for a very long time. But
fair enough, it's okay. I was like today,
not,
I was like,
it's
I was
not,
writing
not officially Frontier endorsed. I don't think that one.
No, we all have personal Twitters, guys.
Yeah.
It's not Frontier Twitters. But I was thinking today, I was like, because I was writing a tweet, and I was like, should I tag Andy in it? And I totally forgot that was your handle, and I was like, oh, well, I did it anyways.
It's fine. I don't think it's too rude.
No, it's all fine.
And I worked out what I did wrong. I hadn't connected that path properly. Sorry for making your white skin look bad.
That's okay.
Right.
Next. What's up next?
That's very cool. Let's open that one. And
ooh, so we're going to get some guests in the park. You already have a 52 park rating going on.
129.
It just jumped
up. Because of that beautiful scenery. Let's see what else we've got on the list. Let me mark that one off so we don't forget.
Cool. You get my style. I like it.
Ooh, that one looks amazing. Tapiri Garden. This will look good in the desert. Oh, look at that.
Oh, yeah, I love that one. Sorry, it was. That is the Topiary Garden by the Adster One.
Fantastic.
And
oh,
that's,
I just put that
yeah,
straight
I thought
to the
that
world.
Was quite a nice little piece. If you, yeah. you can like put the
Gonna
paths
have to
like
put
that.
Put some natural paths around, don't we?
I know. Well, yeah, if you want to take the time to do that, that's fine by me.
I am worried.
Dutch creator.
That if
Build a Coaster. What's the name of the game again? The name of the game, Build a Coaster, is Planet Coaster. And it's called Planet Coaster because we embrace the community creations and these streams show them off to the best that they are.
Also, you don't want to see my built coaster because they're always terrible.
Exactly.
They're always terrible. I sit in the office. I'm just next to James Taylor, one of the designers. He works on RC3 and on Planet Coaster, and he builds the most amazing coasters.
Cool.
And whenever I get stuck and need a really good coaster, I'm just like, James, have you got any coasters in your just saved out as local blueprints? And he just passes a bunch of them. I'm like, yep, that's it.
Nice.
Right, I'm not going to put part in here because it'll take me forever.
It looks beautiful.
But it does look absolutely beautiful.
Really well done.
Lovely
the Adster one,
there.
If you're watching, well done.
Oh, got an entertainer point there too.
I like those. Those are cool.
Yeah, fantastic.
Quick question from Zenith team. Cats or dogs?
Oh, cats. I've got two cats. They're lovely. I do love dogs as well, but cats are best.
There you go.
Cats are
there
best.
You go. All right. What's up next?
What's up next?
What you got going?
Let's have a look. Western Rideskin train station.
Ooh.
And it's good. But I'm going to save that one because we're going to have to build a monorail for that one or a train station for that, aren't we? And
if you want, yeah.
Let's have a shop because we've got all these people here.
And it's sci-fi.
Yeah.
And it's Channel 5 Gaming!
Oh, wow, fantastic.
I know! Sci-fi Missy Goods shop on his workshop right now.
It's wonderful.
I think, if I'm correct, you'd built this on one of your live streams. So do check out YouTube. /Channel 5 Gaming or Twitch/Channel 5 Gaming. Please correct me in the chat if I said something wrong. But yeah, this is a really cool shop
Fantastic.
Complex with Valentine hearts as well and some donuts.
Let's
Love
pop
it.
This one down and have a better look.
Ooh.
This great donuts.
Ooh. And Street Fox coffee. Well
monthly
done.
Profit -277. Well,
that's fine. You're in
doesn't
sandbox.
Have to be, yeah,
we don't
have to be
mind
profitable,
right now.
Oh, look, there we go. We've got some Street Fox coffee.
Lovely. Missy Good. Donuts.
And more coffee. Right.
Coffee
some toilets as well. Toilets as well.
Yeah, because after all those coffee and donuts,
gonna need them,
where
yeah.
are you going to have to go?
I love a little employee door
Life
there as well. Well,
with Bo and Andy.
That's wonderful.
Yeah, really well done. I really like this piece.
We should probably hook this up to some paths so our guests can get here.
Yes, let's do it. Channel 5 subscribe, says 3P Music. There you go. That's what we want.
Yeah. Oh, hang on. Let's turn the length up. It'll take forever otherwise.
Weed store. Sure, if you think so, that's more than fine. But stick around to our 1.2 update mid-April. Because there will be loads more coming to you, and it will be worth the wait. I know that there is a bit of a there's been a bit of a period between Christmas and now, but we're amping up to get some more stuff for you guys, and we're amping up for PAX East as well. It's going to be really really good. Super excited. I've got Sam Denny, spoiler Sam, to come with me to Boston to do all these live streams with me as well. Ed's going to be there. We have lots of streamers who are coming as well. Gosh, okay, I'm going to have to name some of them. We have the guys from Nerd Fusion that are coming. We have Daz Valdez is coming. Zilliness is coming. DJ Knight is coming. I'm just jumbling them all up in my head now because of the Elite. There's also Elite Dangerous streams going on. Goodness me, so many people are coming. So you have lots to watch. It's going to be really
fun.
There you
go, I've got two of them connected.
Well done.
I'm afraid my path connecting skills are clearly not good enough to get all of them.
Aww. There you go.
There we go. They have somewhere to go for their coffee.
They have one of each. They should be fine.
Yeah. But no, that's lovely. I love the little heart-shaped trees as well. That's fantastic.
That's cool, yeah. Anyway, so that's Channel 5 Gaming's Sci-Fi Missy Good shop. So check that out on the workshop or on his YouTube channel as well.
And the bins at the
really
back as well.
Nice.
Wonderful.
Yeah, it's for the extra bit of realism, right? Can go all your trash. 3P Music is coming, that's right, 3P Music, our American ambassador.
Oh, fantastic.
That's going to be exciting. Flabaliki is coming, thank you, Janatha, for being on it. Critic Zeus is coming, Charlie Winsmore is coming. They're slowly coming back in my brain now. We have, I think, in total 21 streamers for Elite and Planet Coaster, so their names are like all over the place in my head right now. But yeah. Thank you, Bloody Kimbo, for putting that in the chat as well. You're 100% correct. PAX East is from 9th to the 12th of March, and we will stream every day from 10 a.m. EST, Eastern Time, so that is -5 from UK, to about 6 p.m. as well. And we will have official streams on the Friday with lots of announcements and everything. And then Saturday and Sunday we'll have streamers coming onto the official streams, and they will be streaming on their own channels as well. Ooh!
Yeah, so we should build some coasters. Here is an amazing coaster. Fantastic flying machines.
This went all the way to the front page of the workshop today.
Wow,
and I saw it and I was like, we have to show this off. It's so cool. And
that
it's called,
cool.
It has a really interesting title, The Fabulous Brothers Present Their Fantastic Flying Machines.
Oh, look at
by
that.
By Zephyr, X-A-P-H-O-R.
That is amazing.
Well done.
The waterway on the side.
And you know what we do with coasters as
well,
right?
We've got to ride them.
We've got to ride them. It's so cool, though. It's very steampunky and piratey, and I like it. I'm excited.
Got some pirate band in there too. Pirate band.
Ooh, I bet that's a triggered one. I bet they're triggered events.
We know what we have to do.
Let's ride the coaster. I am so excited.
Here we go.
Osric says, that's insane! I know!
It's insane.
Creepy music, that's breathtaking! I know! It's really good. Are we gonna go shoot into the distance?
Go.
Did you press test before
I think I did.
Okay, I believe you. It's okay.
Can we see the test dummies?
No.
No.
You have to press test first.
Maybe. No!
No!
I thought I pressed test.
It's fine, it's alright.
We're good.
Ooh, this is exciting! Whoa! Look at our beautiful topiary garden in the distance. Wow! Ooh, that's cool. I wonder if he had it like a little bit in the water or something.
Mm.
Oh, this is really nice. Look at the little hidden train and everything. Ooh, okay. Wow.
I love all the tracks on the ground as well, yeah.
Hope you're okay at home. Don't get dizzy. Whoa, look at the triggered events there. Really nice with the cannon,
yeah.
The gunfire.
This coaster is terrifying. It's amazing, but terrifying.
And now do we get the pirate bed?
Yes! Yes,
see?
There they are.
Well done.
Fantastic.
That's really cool.
That's awesome.
Sorry.
Anyway, what's all that coaster excitement about?
That, I know, right? That's made by Zephyr,
yeah.
So check that out. It should be actually the front page of the Steam Workshop at the moment,
yeah.
Because it was quite popular the past couple of days. So
really
well
cool.
Done for building that. That must have taken
ages,
a lot of time.
Ages, yeah, no, well done.
You're really cool.
And lovely and smoothly banked as
that
well.
That is nice, that little bridge that he made, that I'm pointing at the screen, you guys can see that.
Yeah, this one.
With the barrels, that's cool. Wow. Really, really nice. Love it.
That is really
absolutely
cool.
Love it.
Fantastic.
That reminds me a bit of the one we had. I thought, oh god, it must have been a while ago. It was the disused distillery.
I remember that one.
That was
really
a good one as well. It reminds me a bit of this one. It's really nice. Look at the guests having fun.
They're all going to spend money missy goods. Poor guests, I've only hooked up one
You're
ride
for
them.
You're doing a job, like building a nice little cohesive park there, I think.
Yeah.
It looks nice.
Well,
and he's doing good, isn't he, guys? Give him some love in the chat, please, for Andrew Chappell. Building on stream.
I'm afraid I can't hold anything to our amazingly talented artists and designers, but...
Exactly.
But let's have a pirate battle to go with it. Oh, wow, look at that little boat
Dirk
ride.
Techno, can you just release the April update in March? Sure!
Yeah, I get...
Sure, that wouldn't mess things up at all.
I get in trouble when I do things like that.
Robin Summer, how come you can't play Planet Coaster when you watch the stream? Is it because you don't own Planet Coaster yet? Because if you don't, stick around to the end of the stream. We will be giving away a free copy of the game as well. Ooh, so you can win. Lots of hearts in the chat for you. There you go.
Oh, fantastic.
There you go.
Oh, that is a lovely little boat ride. That is Pirate Battle. Who was Pirate
Battle?
Yeah,
Pirate Battle, sorry.
So I thought I'd put it down next to the wonderful Pirate Band and Western themed coaster here.
Yeah, that's good.
Look at that, that is lovely.
It's made by The Dork, and that is his or her username. I'm not trying to be rude. That's the username, The Dork, making Pirate Battle, and I think that looks really cool.
Oh, fantastic. Oh, I've got another question there.
Oh, yeah, go
for
it.
Which I'll go for, because it gives me a chance to give a giant shout out to all of Frontier's QA,
yes,
who have made Planet Coaster the amazing game it is by telling us when we break things. So, Mr. Adrian SW says, what's the relationship like between programmers and QA people?
Yay!
Well, the relationship's really, really good. We've got really, really great QA people here at Frontier.
Yeah.
And big shout out for QA, because they work super hard checking all of our updates. And we do them an update to the game and we just say, we've changed all these things. Can you just test the entire game again? And Planet Coaster is enormous. It's got so much stuff. It's so difficult for them to test it all. And they have these enormous lists of tests that they go through to make sure everything works. It's fantastic. They do an amazing job. So big shout out to them. But
Yay.
The relationship's great because they are just a kind of a stone's throw away from us.
Yep.
So we often have to get them to come and show us what they're doing, because they'll write up a bug report for us and we'll try and do it and go, I can't make that happen. And the QA have like the magic fingers and they'll come over and just press something and suddenly it'll be like, oh yeah, that's easy to fix.
We got it. That's very true. Yeah, they're absolutely lovely.
Yeah.
Joel, the QA team is amazing. Yes, they are.
They are.
They absolutely are. If any of them are watching, woo, you're awesome.
Right.
So yeah, Pirate Battle.
Pirate Battle is fantastic. It's a lovely, lovely little boat ride.
And I think that kind of answered the other question as well. The one question, and I forgot to write the name down. How do you test the game before it goes live?
Oh, it has so many.
So many
days of testing before build goes live.
Yeah.
We have to be super careful, and even then, occasionally we slip up. And we've definitely had updates. I remember during the alpha of Planet Coaster,
Ooh.
We managed to release a version where just keyboard and mouse input just didn't work for some people, and we were trying to figure it out, going around the office trying to find all the different keyboards and mice to test
this. Trying to play the game and nothing is responding. Oh goodness!
But Yay. I think we got that one eventually. I don't think it was like anybody with a foreign version of Windows. So obviously, most of the people in Frontier have English computers.
Right.
And then one of our render programmers, Gert, who's worked on Planet Coaster. Mm-hmm. He said, oh, I'm trying out my laptop at home and it couldn't get any of the keyboard and mouse to work. And
wow.
We suddenly then twigged that it was if you had a foreign version of Windows, and it was because Windows calls a keyboard something different in foreign languages.
Oh,
and
my
we
goodness.
Were checking for keyboards. That's my boring programming fact, is that we were checking for English word of keyboards and we should have been checking for something else.
Very cool.
Right, enough boring programming.
Hello, Wingardium Livicoaster, thank you for joining us.
Can I play for Alpha Update Tester? I'm afraid we don't do any external build testing. I'm afraid it's all done by our wonderful
it's all
folks
in-house.
In QA.
Yeah. Yeah.
Steampunk Watermill. There we go.
Oh, that's cool.
Steampunk Watermill.
That is made by Zachman the Dangerous. Zachman the Dangerous. And I've been told he's not actually dangerous. He's actually very nice.
Excellent.
But he does make dangerously
around.
Good.
Yeah, that's
workshop
lovely.
Creations.
It's a beautiful little water.
I'm clapping for my own joke. So that's terrible.
Don't worry, bro. They'll all catch up with it.
Yeah, it's fine. don't worry.
Right,
very nice. Oh, it's floating, I
Is
think.
It?
Yeah, just a tad. But just if you put it like a lake and
no,
a little
we're
hill.
Gonna, we're gonna.
Max, Mr. Adrian, by the way, says, nope, not boring at all. I want more stories like that. I told Andy before we started that you guys are super interested in game development and what's going on behind the scenes, so that he shouldn't worry about boring stories because they're all super interesting.
Well, I'm glad that people are interested in our crazy programming
Absolutely.
Stories. Let's tuck this
Absolutely.
One down there.
Abdulaziz is asking, did you expect Planet Coaster to be successful worldwide?
We always hope that it would be successful worldwide. It's like theme parks are one of those like universal language things that are just really cool places to be, aren't they? And this kind of game, it's the only worry for me is that it's got lots and lots of text.
Right.
I know that when in alpha before it was fully translated, we were worried that people from other languages might struggle to pick up some of the like technical terms and things that were in English. Mm. But it's been good. Yeah, yeah. And really early on, I was really keen to get community translations and things working so that everybody could do it. And it's really, really encouraging to see all the different languages that people have translated Planet Coaster into and all the different countries that people play it in.
I know, it's been really nice. Even when you contact like content creators and stuff.
Yeah.
Or when you guys write us from a community at frontier.co.uk and share with us your stuff. Everyone's just from all over the place and it's really nice. It's good. It's a good community we've got going on, guys. Thanks to you! Ooh, what's happening?
I was going to do some training.
Yay!
But I'm worried that.
Love it. Gregor Burns was asking, by the way.
Out here.
Who's your favorite community manager at Frontier?
You see, I can't answer that because if I say
he's actually a nice person.
If I say Bo, Ed will be upset.
He's not watching.
Oh, he will be, and he will tell me later. He'll tell me off.
I know. He'll be like, "What? What?" Okay.
Let's have some comments.
It's okay, Gregor Burns. We didn't need to ask that question. We're all Andy's favorites. He's laughing now. Thanks. I really like, because we're right next to SSD's right skin right now, and he has all these little bubble effects going on, and it's just so nice. Ooh.
I'm going to have to move that down a bit more. My terrible terrain sculpting is put to shame.
I think you're doing a really, really great job of building on stream, because it's not easy. And you're making it look good.
There we go. So. I think we've got our water wheel just dipped into the water there.
Well done. That's great.
This is a bit still in the ground, but let's just pretend that there's been a really heavy wind and the desert's just been blown over there for a bit.
Exactly.
No, that's lovely. It's
very nice.
Full of little details there. It's lovely. It's like steam engine there and all the cogs and things. Fantastic.
Thank you, Zachman, for submitting that on Workshop as well. Looking good.
Yeah.
It's a steampunk water mill. Yeah. There you go.
Steampunk watermill. Let's take that one off the list so I don't forget it.
Exactly, Joel. Joel's right. The entire community team is awesome. Yes, that's true. The entire Planet Coaster team and the entire Frontier team actually is awesome.
We do have an awful lot of awesome people.
I know.
And a really awesome community as well.
Yeah, it's good. Bo, try to say bubble in an angry way. It's impossible. Bubble! It's not possible. I'm already laughing. You try.
Bubble. No, you can't.
It's not possible.
It's too great a word.
Actually, Abdulaziz, Planet Coaster Museum in the works. I'm not sure what you're going for there. But I do remember that, if I'm correct, S.B. Ridley made a YouTube series or a workshop series on famous paintings.
Oh yes, yeah, I remember
which is
seeing
amazing.
That. Seeing the amazing things people have come up with primitive shapes.
Oh,
it really is
so
incredible.
Good.
Yeah,
it's really, really good. Absolutely. Yeah, they're all saying bubble angrily now. It's not possible, guys. I'm telling you. Today, designer has a devil horns. My bubbles, she says. Uh oh.
Anyway, we have got here.
This is nice.
Ooh, this is very nice.
This is the Chinese and Japanese garden by Kalani.
Yeah, look at that. That's
and I
beautiful.
Thought this was a lovely little scenery piece that's happening there. And maybe, I don't know if it's possible, but inside you could put like an entertainment point at some point.
Yeah, I reckon you could get an entertainment point
just
and
get someone
a sneaky little natural path up there.
Exactly.
Get your guests walking
up there. Yes, Esther Ridley's in the chat. I was correct. Yes, my paintings, he says.
Yeah,
exactly.
No, they were amazing. Well, we have a mailing list at work where we send around amazing things that people have done with Planet Coaster.
Yeah, we do.
And some of the things that people have done with the primitive shapes are just incredible.
It's
and
really
it
good.
Must take you so much time to do it.
I know. And it's funny because, it's not funny. It's unfortunate because some of them we can't show on streams because of copyright.
Yeah, yeah. The ones I'm thinking of are definitely in the copyright infringing department, but they were absolutely fantastic.
Just so you know, if you are, because I know, for example, like Dirk Techno is in the chat and stuff. If you are creating things that are copyrighted that we can't always show on the stream, just know that the people here. Everyone who's working all day and they're checking the Steam Workshop, they see your items and there's literal squeals going on of like fangirling and fanboying over stuff that you guys make, even if we can't show it. It's definitely appreciated. So just keep going.
Even our artists will just sit and go, how did they do that?
How? Yes, exactly. It's really, really nice.
That is a lovely,
Japanese
garden.
It's nice and calming to watch as well. Like this could be a stream background too, you know?
Yeah.
Just like a little loop video.
Yeah, if any time you've done a better job of terraforming all the terrain around here.
It's nice. Yeah, go for it. Do your thing.
All right, I'm going to run some paths around here so that our people can walk around here too.
Josh, no, my phone died and I missed some of this amazing stream. Too sad for me. Well, Josh, don't worry. After the stream is over, it will be automatically uploaded to the YouTube channel as well, so you can watch back the parts that you missed. You didn't miss much. Yes, you did. You missed over half. Curse your phone. Very nice.
There we go.
I feel like this is really chill for me. I'm just like backseat building a little bit, and like you're doing such a good job.
Thank you.
I'm really, really proud. It's nice.
I bet you everybody is just thinking. Everybody will be thinking, oh no.
No, everyone's enjoying. It's nice. It's nice to watch people create stuff with, and you know, it doesn't have to be your own stuff. We're doing this Workshop Wonderland.
It's nice to show off everybody else's hard work as well.
3P Music, can you rhyme some of your favorite ones that are copyrighted? No. Oh, goodness. Techie Commander says, hello, Bo. Please send my thanks to the dev team for the game I waited 13 years for. Wow, that's a lovely compliment. Thank you, Techie Commander.
Yeah, thank you.
There you go. If any of the dev team are watching right now, there's your compliment, and I will relay it as well when I'm done with this. Very nice.
Let's see if we can...
Take the clown away.
No clowns?
No clowns, ever. I don't like it.
Does anybody really like clowns?
I don't know. I'm not sure.
What does the chat like?
Maybe
clowns?
innocent children that don't know any better.
Yeah.
Hello, Sate Souffle just tuned in as well.
Going for.
Wow, very nice. Nice little decoration going on.
Kind of hug up hats a bit.
Oh, I was going to say something and I forgot. Do I have that? Like halfway. Yeah, I remember. Let me know, please, in the chat really quickly if the sound is still correct for you, because I'm not sure if I 100% adjusted it back from last week's audio live stream. So if you're, let me know if you can hear the game and hear our voices, if it's loud enough and everything. But I'm assuming it's okay, because I haven't seen any complaints in the chat. So good.
Excellent.
William, I've waited 43 years for this game. Where's my shout out? Hello, William. There you go. There's your shout out, mate.
Yeah.
Sounds okay. Sounds fine. Sound works. Awesome. Thank you. Caleb R says, you need another tree. Not sure of sarcasm. We like trees.
Yeah.
Game is a bit quiet. Okay. Everyone else is happy. No echoes. Thanks, Tom. You know me too well.
There.
I don't hear the game. Oh no. The game's pretty quiet, but that's okay, says Looped Chris. Okay.
Anyway, I think if I
a little bit.
Spend any more time placing flowers, I'm just going to get bored.
Can you do me a quick favor and just press on this little bar really quick?
Of course.
Just one.
Here?
Yeah, just one up. No. So it should be maybe a tiny bit louder now. That's just for the game sound. Yeah.
Excellent.
Yeah. José Fernando Morera. Hi, Bo. Say something in Spanish. Hola. Hola, ¿qué tal, José? That's all I got for now.
Wouldn't really be fair on the audio, guys, after last week's awesome live stream to have the game muted, would it? Right, let's go back and look at some more workshop items. Yeah, my problem is that if I'm playing Planet Coaster at home, I can sit and spend hours and hours and hours decorating things. And as you can see from my amazingly creative row of trees there, I was just like, can't spend ages going through the browser picking different trees. Nobody wants to... You all know all the trees that are in the browser, right?
It's very nice. It looks good. Immersive Roleplay Guild, about to leave, unfortunately. Just wanted to say you made a fantastic game. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
That's all these guys and the Frontier team that are behind us in the building and at home. So they will take that compliment gladly. Ooh,
excellent.
Magnificent foliage, sir, says Stephen. Stephen Bowie.
Now it's nice. I actually worked on getting some of those tree things to render, and then our render programmers took over and made it loads better, so it's fine.
3P Music says, how many Planko words do you speak or know?
I am terrible at other languages. So I'm afraid I don't speak any Planko.
it's difficult.
I have walked past James at James Stan's office and heard him practicing Planko merrily. Right.
Bo, can you speak Planko? I can say hi-yo, la mumel, and then something, Ersa Wipitentifu?
Ah, yes.
That's about it.
From the
something
song.
Something like that.
Yeah.
Omashum. Omashum. Yes.
I remember when that first went in.
Crescendo Chris is saying, ask Andy to speak in binary for us.
Oh, you did.
What?
I don't want to speak in binary. That'll take ages. Too many ones and zeros.
That's very nice.
Plus, I need to start a calculator to do any binary arithmetic anyway.
Ooh, what are you plopping down here?
So this is Small House with Gulpy Soda.
Yes, and this is made by Tim V. Tim underscore V. Small House with Gulpy Soda. And Tim V, I really like his workshop. There's not much going on because I'm assuming it takes him quite some time to create these little buildings. But look.
It's very detailed, isn't it?
It's floating still.
Oh.
Sorry.
I was trying to do it from the bottom of the shot, and clearly I missed. Where's the widget gone? Let's have that down a bit.
But like, there's always there like so much realistic, like little cutesy details and crooked little houses as well.
There we go.
So yeah. Oh, you're cropped off a bit. If you want to.
Sorry, am I?
Yeah.
Shuffled over.
Someone is concerned about your arm.
No, don't worry. Just don't do that. Right, let's give this some path, because I think this deserves to be opened. but let's not make it 6 meters wide, because that will look weird.
Very nice.
Too zoomed in. There we go.
Fly Jason, are there going to be more free rides added? Blah, 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 blah.
Spoilers.
Who knows? I don't know. Guess you'll have to wait and see.
But I did like that screenshot that was on Facebook. That was good, wasn't it?
Yeah, that was a great screenshot. There was a screenshot in a newsletter.
Mm.
Don't know what was going on there. Don't know what was in there.
Sorry, I'm still.
Very nice. Oh, sunrise.
Better. Yeah.
Lovely.
Right. That is a wonderful.
Very good. You're doing a great job
house.
There. Oh, we did this as well.
And all my guests are buying gulpy sodas.
Oh, we did this as well.
Wow. Me too. Mark a few more off.
Yeah.
Did that one as well. I've broken the system by.
No, it's fine. It's fine. You got it.
Evil Hue.
Ooh,
Temple
that's a
of
dark
Spiral.
Ride. No, is it? No, it's a. It's. Actually, I'm not sure if it's
I think
a
it's got a coaster.
It's
got
a coaster,
it's got a coaster
I think.
In it.
Yeah.
It's got excitement for nausea. Let's have a look
confusing
at this.
Them. Oh, boy. Now, Evil Cube makes some really interesting coasters and dark rides as well, so I'm quite excited to.
That looks incredible.
That's cool.
But I probably shouldn't close
it
out.
It all just really works together as well.
Yeah, let's come over here where there's more room.
Very nice.
No, there's not enough room there.
8-bit Josh is here as well. Hello.
There we go. Oh, too low. There we go.
Creepy music. I'm not giving you any more hints about the screenshots. Hello, Tobias. Thank you for joining us as well. Ooh.
That does look really cool.
This is so Evil Cube. Don't know if you're watching tonight, but that looks great.
It's decent. Well, I do want to ride it.
Excited.
I do want to ride it. Let's just go for test.
Outside is really great. What is that thing?
Let's find out.
An Evil Cube is really good with trigger defense as
yeah,
well.
Yeah, we've got a trigger door right there.
I have my fingers crossed for this one. Bo, no, Bo is not short for anything. Bo is my name. Whoa! Look at that skull.
Oh,
nice.
Wow. Yeah, look at that.
Hello. Ooh, very detailed. Yay! Whoa!
Oh, look at that.
Ooh, with the smoke effects and everything. Oh, this is lovely, isn't it? Look at that inside.
That is really cool.
Oh, nice! It's like a temple.
Yeah.
Like you go.
Oh, it's a spinning coaster as well.
Oh my god!
Oh, fantastic! Didn't even notice that.
I know! I was like, what? That's awesome. Yay! Whoa! Yay! Oh gosh, I'm sorry guys at home if you didn't expect this. I hope everyone's okay.
Oh.
That is cool.
It's very,
look at
very
the
cool
detail.
Indeed. Yeah, and it's a wonderful compact coaster as well. Whenever I've already said I rubbish having coasters, but why I really struggle to get like really compact coasters together. They're always I can build like a big coaster. That's it. That's much easier. This is a fantastic little compact one. Look how close the track is.
Oh wow!
Terrifying.
I love it.
But wonderful.
It's really well built, actually.
Yeah.
Whoa! Oh, that's spinning cool. Around the,
look at that.
That's so cool. I can't.
Exit right. Fantastic.
Oh, thanks, William. I'll take that as a compliment.
Right.
Oh, Jeroen, I actually don't know that. But yeah, people did call me Bobo when I was little, yeah. Sometimes they still do because I'm not a tall person, so. Very nice. Thank you, Evil Cube, for having that on your workshop as well.
That's really, really, really nicely themed all around, isn't it? Look at that. Fantastic.
Temple of Spiral.
Yeah.
That looks great.
That kind of explains the spinning coaster, doesn't it? Oh, look at that. Take a moment to look, and there's obviously nice block breaks and things because I can see multiple cars going around it. Fantastic.
Very nice.
But terrifying. I think spiral. I absolutely love roller coasters, but I think spiral coasters look. I've never been on one, and they look really, really terrifying. Mm-hmm. I would love to go on one. I don't even know if there are any in the UK.
I don't know. I haven't been to a UK theme park yet.
No, oh, what?
I know.
Oh.
Because I...
Well, most of them are shut at the moment anyway, aren't they?
Yeah,
it's just winter time.
Lee just joined. Who is Andrew? Andrew is the lead programmer on Planet Coaster and they're doing a fantastic job on the stream tonight as well. And he's currently building a beautiful park for us.
Let's go with building a park. I wouldn't necessarily go with beautiful. Every creation's in the park, beautiful, but...
He's also very humble and doesn't like to take compliments.
No.
So please keep putting them in the chat for him.
So this is the Beaufort's Haunted Castle.
According to Nemi, sorry for interrupting you, but there's the Spinball Wizard in Alton Towers, which is apparently a spinning coaster.
Yeah, I haven't been on that one.
So there you go.
Thank you, Nemi.
That looks like a dark ride to me.
I think it does, doesn't it? Let's
Leonardo
DiCaprio.
Well done, Dirk Techno. I see what you did there, and I got your joke, and you're on my level. I like it. Whoa, there's a lot of effects going on.
Yeah, that's the thing about moving blueprints, isn't it? Suddenly there's just bubbles and smoke everywhere. Well, let's pop that one down there.
Yay!
Let's do our little...
Let's see if I remember who made this. Oh, goodness. We did this one. Is that a Burg Falkenstein Haunted Castle by Cookie Boone? Am I
correct?
Oh,
no, I pressed things on my number pad, bro.
What have you done? Oh, just go to 3. Here we go.
There we go. Sorry.
You're fine, don't worry about it.
Bo even told me before the stream, don't press things on the number pad.
It's okay.
Dark. There we go.
Yay.
Let's test our dark ride.
I'm excited. I think it's that one. I think it was by Cookie Bone. Burg Falkenstein Haunted Castle. So it's haunted, so let's see.
I love the dark white people creating Planet Coaster. It's truly amazing.
It was the best thing so far, I think.
Oh, also, Dragon's Fury in Chessington World of Adventure. I haven't been to Chessington World of Adventure since I was about 10. But I did not know they had a spinning coaster, so thank you, Josh.
Wow. I'm feeling spooky.
Yeah.
I hope that, because we can't hear what you guys are hearing, I hope you guys are hearing some spooky music. Oh my goodness, look at that.
So much smoke.
I know. I'm scared it's going to be like hands like trying to grab you or something. Very cool. Spooky bow.
Oh, that is very spooky indeed. I'm loving the red tree there.
As a thylator too. Why do you all have such difficult usernames for me to pronounce? I guess you'll just have to wait and see. But keep posting on the forums and social because the dev team do check that out. They see your suggestions. And as we know from experience, they implement a lot of things that that you guys ask for. So just try your luck there.
Brian Hopkins says, are you a fan of coasters in real life, Andy? Yes, I am. I love roller coasters. I try and go ride in theme parks whenever I possibly can.
Very cool. Sorry.
Oh, did we just miss something?
Going to a dragon.
Oh, look at that.
Dragon's lair over there. Unintentional rhyme. Hello. Unfortunately, the dragons just look so happy. Like, they're so cute.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Oh, wow, look at that.
That's cool.
Is that a...
What's he doing?
Glowing night wet, going night there, wow.
Whoa, that's nice.
I love the kind of shape, the coming, the pulling the roof in down like that as well.
It's creepy,
kind of feels,
isn't it?
Yeah, it makes it feel claustrophobic.
Yeah. Very nice.
Let's have a look at him. Look at that. Oh, wow, we just missed Dogbot's off.
Very nice. Oh, thank you, Samuel, for that compliment. That means a lot to me. And thank you very much for saying that. Wow.
That was fantastic.
Bam! No, there's more!
There's more! Oh, wow, I thought we were coming back into the station, but no.
Look at that creepy... Okay,
case
so
there.
Cookie
wow.
Bone has made incredible use of the trigger defense, I have to say.
Yeah.
Like, give credit where credit's due. Like, that's really nice.
Yeah, no,
things are lighting up at the right time and happening at the right time. So yeah,
yeah,
really,
yeah,
really
big,
cool.
I'm a big fan of the trigger defense.
Oh,
what
yeah,
have we got
this
here?
Is cool. I like this. I really like the little strobe lighty thing. Oh my god!
Oh wow, fire as well.
That's awesome.
That is fantastic.
That was a nice little finisher there.
Yeah, that's lovely.
Well done, Cookie Bone, if you're watching. Really, really cool. Gameplay is hi, can you call my name? There you go, and welcome to the stream. Thanks for joining us tonight.
Yeah. Well, that was fantastic. Let's jump off this one. And leave my guests to
Very
ride it.
Nice.
Although my guests won't be riding it because I haven't built them paths to it.
It's okay. If you want...
These poor folks down here, they are stuck in my theme park.
And you can only go to the carousel as well.
Priority passes are for suckers. Well, I agree. I agree with you, Doyle Lowry. I agree with you.
Nice.
Right.
If you want, at the end of the stream, I can upload this park to my workshop.
And then
and
we
people
can see what other wonderful things people can do with it. That sounds a wonderful idea.
Yep. Do a little, we can do a little Andrew Chappell forum post.
Yeah.
Saying,
I'll grab
hello.
Some. We can see what.
He likes being on the forum, so.
I do. Right.
Do you mind if we go a bit over time as well?
No, that's
we'll
fine.
We'll finish all the workshop
yeah.
items. So, yeah, you can hang with us a bit longer tonight.
That one is the haunted concert.
Oh, sing that's the Dutch fun. National anthem. No, I am not going to do that. Absolutely not.
Let's go make this not nighttime. There we go.
Very nice.
And Country Inn. Food and food
oh,
shop and toilet.
Yeah.
Let's have one
that
of those.
That is the quaint Country Inn submitted by me today by Tilly Twos. I hope you're still here in the chat. I've seen you in the beginning. I hope you're still lingering around. Yeah, Tilly Twos makes some really nice buildings as well. I love this one.
Let's bring that one around.
A little Country Inn. If your guests like to, you know, stay and have a prolonged experience in your park, they can stay there.
Fantastic.
It's hard
go.
To aim sometimes, isn't
yeah.
it?
Yeah.
I know.
Let's see, is that about right?
Yeah, very good.
Oh, that's not too bad.
Well done.
I think that's about right.
Look how cute, though. Look how adorable that looks.
Yeah, no, that is lovely. Nicely decorated with the ivy. Big
yeah.
shout out to all of our artists who create all of the trees and things in Flat Coaster.
Absolutely.
They've done a wonderful job.
And what I like about a lot about Tilly Tews' building is that there's always scenery. Around it, there's always like so you always kind of have a feel of you know where it can go and the overall like atmosphere of the building and then just the detail and the coloring is always like
yeah.
just right. I really
yeah,
really enjoy
that's
that.
Lovely.
So well done. If you're
and
still there.
Got a little cheap beef in there too.
Tilly Twos is still there. There you go. Exactly,
oh,
Joel. Like Joel says, nice job on the foliage. I agree.
Yeah, that's very nice indeed.
It's very atmospheric and very cutesy. Oh, look, and we're getting
path.
A path.
Yeah.
Osric is asking how long you've been working at Frontier and what you did before that.
How long have I been working at Frontier? I came to Frontier straight from university.
What?
I've been working at Frontier since 2008.
Oh, wow.
So I've been here quite a while. I've worked on
so
lots of different titles, yeah.
That's cool. So we'll have a party next year then.
I hope so.
Very cool.
Night is there. There
that looks
go.
Great.
I think we hooked up some toilets
yeah, it's
there.
Good.
Yeah. Let's just quickly actually add it to the path.
That's so nice. It's just so relaxing to play.
Yes, it's a very, very nice game to just sit back and work on.
Arno is asking, what do we think of Rudy's famous recreation of a very famous coaster?
Oh, that one that we can't. Yes.
It's amazing.
Yeah, no, it's amazing.
It's amazing. It's so well done. It looks just like the real thing.
That's another one that we all saw in the office and went, wow.
I sent it around as well. Yeah. Everyone. So that happens sometimes too when we find really cool finds. They get sent around the office and people are like, what? This is so cool. Yeah. So yeah, even if you don't always see yourself appear on the stream,
you are being appreciated
behind the scenes, 100%. Right. Yeah, and if you're not subscribed yet to Rudy Renkamel on YouTube, you must do it. He makes
the most amazing
stuff.
Connect things, yeah.
So good. And I think he's doing a collaboration with delayed designer and Silverette and some people's as well. So yeah, that's another thing that I love so much about the community, that you guys find each other as well. You find each other through YouTube or Twitch or even the workshop, and you connect with each other, and then you do collaborations, you make parks together or items together or YouTube videos together. And it's really heartwarming to see for us, because that's you know, exactly the kind of spirit we want to foster with Planet Coaster. That's what Planet Coaster is about.
Absolutely.
So it's really nice.
So this one is a Egyptian inverted station, and
I will
put the station down and we have a look at how amazing it is. I'm not going to build a coaster because it'll take me forever.
This is by Euthyrus, one of our new featured creators this month. Featured creators, by the way, if you're not sure what that means, they appear, the five people that appear when you open the game, when you see your globe. These are the five people with crowns that we promote every month. We promote some different people that are creating exceptional stuff in the workshop, and that we feel you should subscribe to or check out or
give them a click,
be inspired by.
Give them a click and take a look at the amazing things that they've been building.
Yeah, absolutely. And this one is especially interesting, I think, for Janatha, because I know that Janatha is in the chat and he makes some Egyptian-inspired buildings as well. So yeah, maybe Janatha and Euthyrus, maybe you can get together and create an Egyptian sort of park. That would be cool.
Definitely floating again. Let's go there. I think that's better.
Very nice.
Yeah.
And what's also funny is that Egyptian is not technically a Planet Coaster theme.
No,
but
it isn't,
somehow
is it?
You guys
look at that.
Make it work. Like.
Yeah, that is fantastic.
Really, really cool.
Yeah, well done. That is really awesome. Oh, look, have a little water particle there as well.
That's
fantastic.
Really, really nice.
Yeah, somebody asked earlier what my favourite coaster is, and I think one of my favourite coasters is probably Nemesis Alton Towers, which is one of the first ones I went on, and still I just end up going back again, and it's fantastic.
Yeah, I think I accidentally made a collaboration between Rudy and the Lady Designer that doesn't exist.
You just made one happen. Oh wow, fantastic!
Maybe I made one happen. Yeah, I don't know. I just assumed because everyone's friends, so.
Yeah.
Very nice.
Oh, I cancelled my advance move as well.
Can we finish around 8 p.m. because I don't want to miss the giveaway. Oh, Harry Blaze, I'm so sorry. I'm pretty sure we're going to go over time with this one. We'll try 8:15. We'll aim for that. We'll aim for 8:15.
Sorry, it's been too much good stuff. There we go. That's better. That's more. Less well.
You are working with Rudy.
Floating.
See, I wasn't confused. Oh god, the chat is going past me at this point. I'm sorry, Lady Designer. I knew you were. I doubted myself. I shouldn't do that. You know when you're talking like on the top of your head and you're like, that's it, that's a fact, and then you're like, you start second guessing yourself, and you're like, wait a second.
Oh, look at that.
We've maybe got, not.
We've got a skin for the scissor. Fantastic.
Yes. Let's place that.
Let's have a scissor first of all. Where have you gone, scissor? Where have you gone?
Go to the S for scissor.
Yeah. We'll just search for it. Come on.
Ooh, there we go.
Yeah.
The scissor, everybody.
Oh, that one. Down over here. No. I wonder if I have enough room for that. No. Let's. Make sure we're not crowding the ride, the beautiful ride skin.
Someone is singing the Dutch anthem in the chat and it's just throwing me off so much. Like,
look at that.
We should come up with a Planko national anthem. A Planko international anthem, I should say. Because everyone is included. That would be fun. What's going on there?
I don't know. Have we managed to get like two blueprints in one or something?
I think maybe. So this is Zenith team. So Zenith, I'm not sure if you're still in the chat, but that's an interesting blueprint you've got going on there, mate.
Yeah, I think it might have a bonus track ride in there as well.
Yeah.
Let's just leave that one floating for the time being, and we'll go and crop it out later.
Because the actual ride skin is really cool.
Yeah, it's very pretty, isn't it?
So yeah, where the arrow is pointing is where the entrance should be. I think that's how he creates things.
Excellent.
Oh, it's the coaster that runs the triggered events, of course.
Yeah. Ah, yes. Yeah.
Thanks, chat, for helping out. We were, like, confused for a second. Oh, he's streaming at the moment. Okay. Nice. You have to run the coaster to make the triggers work. Yeah, we got it. Yeah, so I think the coaster track might be slightly out of bounds.
Ah,
so, yeah, that's why it might be difficult to
Let's rotate it around so it's definitely
not. Yeah,
there
you go. That might
be
better.
That's looking better, isn't it? Maybe. Oh man, I'm making Zenitim look bad.
That's
and
okay.
My wide skin placement look bad.
Exactly, Jose. Jim Guthrie, we need a Planet Coaster Anthem. We don't have to ask Jim Guthrie, we can even ask our beautiful audio team. Or James Stant.
Yeah.
Maybe we can ask James Stant for an international Planet Coaster Anthem. How about that? We all have to learn it, guys, and then when we have like a community meet or something, we literally have to sing it together.
Nice.
And be extra nerdy. Bo, do a backflip. Sure. Just press X. Aha! Is it working?
No, it's still
not letting you do it.
Let's,
If not, we can just place the ride skin and we'll just pretend this
yeah,
is in there.
Yeah, let's place the ride skin. I might remove the...
Yes, Pierre, technically the main menu music is the Planet Coaster Anthem, but let's have some Planko words to them that mean nice things. I think that would be fun.
No, it is determined to not let me place this.
So yeah.
It is so hard to not spoil something.
Apparently,
right
there's
now.
It's okay. Apparently, there's text on the arrows that Zenith team put there, so we.
Oh, let's go have a look at that.
We can read that.
Right.
Whoa!
Line
this
up,
end up
with the control booth. Delete the signs and arrow.
Aha!
Oh, it is a very, very fine looking ride skin, and I am sorry that I have messed up placing it.
The Ballad of Tentafu is the Planko anthem. That would be funny.
I think it's important that the Planko anthem is definitely in Planko's anthem is definitely in Planko.
Yeah.
Let's fire off our triggers here and take a look.
Ooh, stuff's moving.
Oh yeah, look at that.
Is it triggering already? I don't know.
It definitely went all the way around.
Should be, maybe if we make it dark. Nighttime, yeah.
Yeah.
There we go.
Oh,
there
that's
we go.
Better. There we go.
Wow.
Oh, fantastic.
That was cool. That was cool.
Yeah.
Look at that. I do have to say, like, Zenith team is the master of light events. Like, he made the rainbow coaster as well, and this wicked, what was it called? Zenith team, help me out. This beautiful indoor water ride that you made. Ugh. Magic something.
Oh, Alan Roberts says, the text tells you what to do, so why not line up the booth? Okay. Okay.
We've been at this for a long time.
Yeah. Let.
It's okay. Sometimes things don't work on the stream, guys. It's okay though. Don't pressure Andy. Be nice. Oh, yay!
Oh my God, that was so easy.
It was the magic words.
Thank you, Aaron.
We needed the magic words.
Then let's.
That's
let's do it.
So
let's do it
cool.
justice properly. And
that's so
oh,
cool.
No.
You have to edit it first. Edit the blueprint, and then you can delete it.
Oh, no, I just clicked the wrong thing.
Oh boy.
Dealing.
Magic something. I'm sorry, Zenith team.
Building.
I can't think of the name right now.
Let's go through and delete the signs.
See, they're all... Yes. Give some love and Andy for placing
there
them.
There we go.
Goodness, it's hard.
Thank you, Aaron. But that looks even better. I'm going to ride it now. No, I made such
very
a mess of it.
Very cool.
Look at that.
Oh, look at your beautiful park in the distance as well. This Missy Good and a coaster. That's nice.
And a flying ship.
Yes.
Fantastic. I forgot to test it.
It's okay.
Yeah. Never mind.
Feeling the pressure now.
Yeah.
Though.
Yeah. Cool. Thank you, Zenith Team. I will.
Oh, Magical Mountain. Thank you, Zenith Team. That was the other ride that I meant.
I will leave that. The secret source of triggers hidden up there. But obviously, if we're building the park properly, we bury it in the ground so it was not to be seen by anybody.
Ooh, secret. All right.
Next one.
We still have a few left.
Yeah.
To show off.
How are we doing for time? If we run horribly
over. We're
fine.
It's 5 past 8, so go for it. Ooh, yes.
We've got, here. We've got
another feature
Western
creator
Mexican
of the
train
month.
Station. Oh, wow.
Hexer Zero.
That's pop.
Hexer O? Hexer Zero? I don't know. I always say it wrong, probably. But yeah, again, an amazing feature creator with lots of detailed builds. And this is the start
of a monorail.
Station of a monorail.
Or
yeah,
probably a Tony Express,
ride,
yeah.
Wow,
that is beautiful.
Crazy. I want to be transported.
Oh,
there.
And we've got a hot dog squad on the roof.
That's nice.
And a Monsieur Frites as well.
Monsieur Frites, as the lady designer would say, Monsieur Frites.
Oh, and we're even more shops on the map. Fantastic.
So nice. Yeah, it's like a little village. Hype train is here.
Yeah, we've got ourselves a cowboy.
Nice.
Fantastic.
I wonder what Hexer is hyped for. Could it be the 1.2 update?
I hope so.
Could it be PAX? I don't know. We're certainly hyped. I'm hyped.
Oh, yeah.
Super cool.
Yeah, that's fantastic. Well done.
Yeah, so check out Hexer as well as one of the featured creators on the globe of Planet Coaster. Have a look at his workshop because it's worth it. It's really good stuff.
Yeah.
Yay! Ooh, the Tomb of the Dauphin, number two. Made by Nefer Mansur. And I thought this was a really, like, creepy little centerpiece in a way.
It should be a bit lower. Got a floating
Like, it's creepy.
There. Yeah.
It's creepy, but it's not doing anything. It's not hurting you. But, like...
I wonder, should we have this
light
here?
Yeah, it's, I think it's like there.
Just go there, isn't it?
Yeah,
there we go.
But just look at it, like, that's such a cool, like, themed area centerpiece, I find, for, like, a big plaza or something.
Yeah.
And have that in the middle, and then, like, spooky sounds playing, and you don't know what's going to happen. It's pretty cool.
Oh, I'm loving the hidden lights under the ground to create this wonderful, wonderful effect. Well done.
Can you see the thing in full as well?
Yeah, let's zoom out. Oh, look at that.
Look at that tower, it's really good.
Wow, fantastic.
Very nice. Really like it.
Especially at nighttime, properly scary
as well. Yeah, it's good.
Fantastic.
It's good. So yeah, there you go. That is the Tomb of the Dauphin number 2, made by Nefermancer. It's very beautiful, I really enjoy that. This I'm excited about. Sorry, just got really excited. I've been waiting for this one.
At that. It's a lot of lights.
Yes.
Fantastic.
This is Maison de Noël, and I know it's Christmas themed and stuff, but oh my goodness, guys. So I've been keeping my eye on Kovard, who is the creator of this. Kovard has been exploding in the workshop with amazingly detailed stuff. So if you're watching Kovard, please get in touch with me on Steam or at community@frontier.co.uk because I absolutely love your stuff and I would love to feature some more of you. And it's just so cool.
He's floating a bit. Sorry, guys.
That's okay. But
it is very beautiful, isn't it? Look at that.
Yeah. So,
so many
nighttime
lights. Yeah.
And it's very... it's very, very over-the-toppy kind of detailed, but in a way that it works.
Yeah,
very
that's beautiful, isn't it?
It's so cool. And then when you make it a daytime as well, just the colors of it.
Look
how nice.
Yeah.
And it's this whole workshop is full of like like brightly colored things like this, like brightly colored castles and houses and beautiful creations. I really, really enjoy your workshop. So, yeah.
That is fantastic.
We will see more of Kovard, I'm 100% sure. Awesome. It's very impressive stuff.
Yeah, that
like
is
the colored
really,
icing and stuff that made
really
the fences.
Beautiful.
Like, so cool. Like, who thinks of that? You guys do.
Yeah.
You well guys done. Think of that. Really cool. Yeah, I was very excited to show this off. I'm happy.
It's beautiful.
Wow, c'est magnifique, says Dirk Techno.
So what have we got three, we're down to the last three. We've got Caribbean Coaster Station. That's our Caribbean Coaster Station.
Ooh, yes. So this is me, Tommy, if you're still here, Tommy T067. I will post the list in the YouTube description as well.
Fantastic.
So nice. It's also very nice.
That around so we can have a better look at
again,
it.
Caribbean is a theme that we don't really support in. Well, I mean, we have the pirate theme, I guess. That kind
of works
together.
Yeah, it's kind of close.
But people have been making like kind of like a Mediterranean crossover with it. And that
people
that really
build the most amazing things out of parts that we don't even remotely expect them to be used for some things. And it's fantastic.
So yeah, this is a coaster station. I do believe it was for an inverted coaster. Correct me if I'm wrong.
The other one was an inverted. Let's see if we can find the. Does it have a coaster station in there?
It should have something. I mean, there was a queue description as well, but we don't have to do that. But look at that on the inside and stuff. So that like when your guests are walking around in the queue, they're still so entertained by all the beautiful stuff that they're seeing.
Fantastic.
So very nice. Wow.
Yeah, that is very nicely done.
Super cool. Yeah, I'm assuming that's where the coaster would go, like through that area. Yeah.
Yeah, I think this is just a blueprint for just the station, which is fantastic. So you can go put whatever coaster type you want in there.
Walk inside, guys. Yes.
Oh, look at that.
Yeah, there you go.
There we go.
Oh, that's nice. Very well done, Tommy.
Yeah.
This is lovely. Really, really
fantastic.
Nice.
I love the detail.
I enjoy that.
Build a fantastic queue through here as well.
I love this. This area is so cool. That's really nice. And I think you could have some water going on in there as well, like water effects. The queue going through there.
Yeah. Fantastic.
Ooh, pretty. We like this.
Yeah,
we like this a lot. So this question was an older question from Dirk Techno as well. Mm-hmm. When we were developing the game, did you use a game engine or did you make something yourself? I mean, we used the Cobra, obviously.
Yeah,
so we
have our own game engine that we write here. We've got lots of really, really awesome programmers, and we have written the Cobra engine, which we use some other bits and pieces. Mm-hmm. So we have like scale form for our GUI and things like that. But most of the things we write in-house, and we created the engine from Planet Coaster.
Cool.
For Planet Coaster to be the best we possibly could.
Yay! Go Cobra engine. Go programmers.
Yeah. Right, last two. We must let
Very
everybody go
nice.
And do our giveaways and
two.
Things. We've got Fairy Tale Shops.
Fairy Tale Shops by Nemu.
It's
not the orange fish. Nemu with a U. And this was you know I'm a sucker for fairy tale theme, so look at this. It's so cute.
A hot dog squad.
I want to live in a house that's just grown like overgrown with poison ivy. Or ivy, not poison ivy. Lol.
Yeah. I mean that might be a bit more interesting. But, that is beautiful, isn't it? Well done.
It's so nice.
Let's go and have a look at it in full. No, if you look, there we go.
It's not too big. Can you make it nighttime? I do believe there was some little.
Let's.
I thought there was some little lighting effects going on. I'm not sure. Yay! Yes, exactly. There's nice little lights going on.
Love it.
It's so good. It's so good. Well done.
Very nice.
Yeah, not poison ivy, Mo, says Osric. Yes, you're correct. I misspoke once again. Second language.
I think that means that. Oh, no, we did Temple of the Spiral.
Yeah,
we did Temple
it's done.
Of the Spiral already.
I was going to say because I ticked everything off my list.
Fantastic.
So I was like, I
Which
missed
is me
one.
Not ticking things off here.
So, yay! I mean, can we have a little
yeah,
overview
let's
of
have
the
an
park
overview
that
of
we've
the,
had
of
so
park.
Far?
All those people who are stuck going on their one ride into their shops.
Ooh, hi, Rudy! Thanks for joining us!
There is the temple. That's fantastic.
Temple of Spiral.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
That fire
that
as well. Terrifying.
If you put that in the chat right now, what was your favorite workshop item that you saw this evening? I'm curious to know.
Yeah.
I like all of them.
No, they are all really, really good.
I have to say, I do really enjoy the ride skins that people make because it's just such a convenient thing to
Yeah, it's beautiful to be able to put when you're building a part to be able to just put something that just fits.
Yeah.
He says. Yeah. Didn't quite line that part up. But it's just mostly just fits.
The temple ride, the twister ride skin. Ooh, all of them for sure. Says Tilly
Two. The scissor ride skin was really
good. Scissor ride skin, temple of spiral, flying machine coaster. Yeah, the flying machine coaster is really good as well, actually.
Yes, look
the
at that.
The dark ride was really good. The Channel 5 Gaming's food court's really nice. Oh my goodness.
Yeah, there's been so much good stuff in this.
Ah, Tim V's little house, the beautiful topiary.
Oh, I wish I'd put proper paths around here. That would have been fantastic.
Very good.
But we're already too far over time.
Yes, we are. We're so late. It's quarter past eight. That's what we promised Harry Plays. I'm not sure if Harry Plays is still there. We did promise.
Mm.
Would you like to save the park?
Yes, let's save the park.
And then we will upload it to Steam and we'll save it as Chapsland. Good. We'll upload it to my Steam account. I will put the Steam URL in the forums. And if you wish, you can continue building in Andrew's park and make it epic.
Yeah.
And then share it with him. Share your creations
come
with him.
Post it on the forums and let me see what amazing things you do with my largely unfinished part.
let's go over here and look at the beautiful background again. Look at it.
Yeah.
Yay! Can we see the coaster?
There we go.
It's so nice. Thanks again, Luke, for doing that for us. I'm really enjoying sitting in front of it. Thank you guys for watching. But before we go, let's do a little giveaway.
Yes.
So I think if you put in the chat hashtag Chapsland, because we lovingly call you Chaps in the office. So hashtag Chapsland in the chat for a free copy of Planet Coaster. Right now, I'll give you 30 seconds to do that. And if you don't own the game yet, this is your chance to win one. Yeah. If you do own the game, you can give it to a friend.
Yeah.
So nice. You can play together, pass parks back and forth. Ooh, look at this. Chapsland.
Yeah.
Yay. Did you have a good time coming back?
I did have a very good time.
Good.
Thank you to everybody, and I hope I answer some of your questions, and the people who I didn't, come post them on the forums and I will try and answer them.
Yeah, do we answer this one? What's your favourite theme park in real life?
Theme park in real life.
From Super Yannick in the chat.
Yeah, I reckon from the UK it's probably got to be Wong Towers. It is wonderful.
I really have to go.
Oh yeah, you should definitely go.
When it's open again,
I'll go. Yeah, a few months time it's open again.
Chapsland. Okay, and 3, 2, 1, stop! Spamland, exactly. Stop spamming the chat. We are going to pick a random number.
Do you
have a favorite number? Don't go too low. Let me have a control F over there. Chapsland.
Let's go with 42.
42, all right. We are going to go. Fingers crossed for number 42. What's the meaning of life, Andrew?
Well, I think you'd have to ask the Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy.
Let's ask Artilius. Artilius, congratulations. You just won a free copy of Planet Coaster, the game. And audio is out of sync, really. Did someone just... Someone freaked me out. You know how I am with this. Don't do that. So Artilius, congratulations on winning a free copy of the game. If you could please send this YouTube account a message to verify your identity, and then also send me a message at community@frontier.co.uk. Let me show you, just in case. Wow! community@frontier.co.uk and tell me, hey, it's me, I won. And then I will get you a Steam code, and you can either play it yourself or give it to a friend.
Absolutely.
And then also, remember, like I told you in the beginning, if you want to be a featured creator, so one of those 5 lovely people that we show every month on the globe when you start the game, send a message to community@frontier.co.uk as well. Let me know your workshop link so I can check you out. If you have any cool items that you want to share on the stream or on the Facebook Lives that me and Ed do on Friday, send them our way, and we will feature you and give you a proper shout out. And yes.
Yeah, thank you very much for watching.
Thanks for coming.
No,
and then last but not least, I always forget this part. Darn. We have a streamer of the week. And this week I've picked someone who is still in the chat and who's had already a few shout-outs this stream, but why not have some more? Go to Channel 5 Gaming right now, youtube.com/c/Channel 5 Gaming. Makes amazing videos, very detailed park, is currently working on the Yeti Park, I do believe. And I have to say, our dev team is very much enjoying your videos as well. So give him a sub. It's really, really worth it. He makes amazing videos, and that's it. Streamer of the week. So awesome. There you go. If you stream as well, community@frontier.co.uk. Wow, look, it just turned into daylight. community@frontier.co.uk, if you want us to promote your channels, no problem. And we'll be back next week, 7 p.m. GMT on Wednesday, with a new guest and a new community stream. So I will see you then. Thank you, Andy, for joining me tonight.
Thank you for having me, and thank you to everybody for watching.
Woo! And see you next week, guys. Bye!